Hi, this is Marty from Blue Lightning TV. I'm going to show you how to create the look of neon tube signs. You can apply this technique to text as well as to graphics. I provided a Photoshop PSD file that has two layers, a brick wall and a darkened version of that wall. Its link is in my video's description or project files. When you first click the link, you'll probably see only the dark wall, but have no fear. When you open the file in Photoshop, you'll see both layers. I also provided the links of the fonts that I used in the intro. However, feel free to use whatever font you like. Just make sure it's not too narrow or too thin. The first step is to set our text or graphic. If you're using a graphic, make sure it's a high contrast black and white image. Since the tubes of a neon sign all have the same thickness, make sure all the lines of the graphic have the same thickness as well. If parts of your graphic have thick, solid shapes, I'll show you how we can create shapes for the neon tubes. In this tutorial, we'll use text. Before we type out our text, let's check our foreground and background colors. If they aren't black and white respectively, press D on your keyboard. We want white to be our foreground color. To reverse them, press X. Open your Type tool and Type Picker. Pick a font you'd like to use for this project. We'll adjust its size in a moment. Click on your document and type out your text. To adjust its size, highlight your text, and at the top, hover your cursor over the type icon, and when it changes into a scrubby slider, click and drag it to the left or right to decrease or increase the size of your text. To reposition it, open your Move tool and drag your text. Since this font is too thick for neon tubes, I'll show you how to create usable shapes from it. Make a copy of your text by pressing Ctrl or Command J. Hide the original text layer. Right-click or secondary-click on the top text layer to open the flyout list, and click Rasterize Type. We'll convert the text layers into a smart object so we can modify it non-destructively and to allow us to replace it with other text without having to redo most of the effects. To do this, shift-click the original text layer to make it active as well. Click the icon at the upper right and click Convert to Smart Object. Double-click the thumbnail of the smart object to open its source. To see our text better, we'll place a black layer behind it. To do this, make the bottom layer active and Control or Command-click the New Layer icon to make a new layer below the active layer. To fill it with black, press Control or Command plus Delete to fill it with our background color. Control or Command-click the Rasterize Text layer to select its shape. Go to Select, Modify, and Contract. Contract the selection by 7 pixels. Then click OK or press Enter or Return. Press the Delete key to delete the areas inside the selection. Deselect it by pressing Ctrl or Command D. Hide the black layer and close the smart object. When you see this message, click Yes to save the changes. Now we have text that's usable for our neon. Double-click an empty area of the smart object to open its layer style window. Click Outer Glow. Click the color box and pick a color for the general color of your neon sign. Near the end of this video, I'll show you how to easily and quickly change its color. If you want to use the same color I'm using, type into the hexadecimal field E402FF. Then click OK. The blend mode is linear dodge, and the opacity is 50%. The technique is softer, the spread is 1%, and the size is 125 pixels. Click the arrow next to the contour thumbnail to open the contour presets, click the gear icon, and click the small or large list. Click half round. The range is 50%. Make a copy of the text layer by pressing Ctrl or Command J. Double-click Outer Glow to open it in the Layer Style window. Change the Blend Mode to Soft Light and its Opacity to 80%. The Spread is 0. The Size is 35 pixels. And the Contour is Linear. Click Drop Shadow. The Blend Mode is Linear Burn. The color is black, and the opacity is 15%. The angle is 40 degrees. The distance is 15 pixels. The spread is 10%, and the size is 10 pixels. The contour is linear. Click Color Overlay and the color box. In the hexadecimal field, I'll type in FF7EFF, which is a bit lighter than the outer glow. Once you pick or type in your color, press Enter or Return. Click Inner Glow. The blend mode is normal, the opacity is 100%, and the color is white. The technique is softer, the source is center, the choke is 0%, and the size is 0 pixels. The contour is linear. Go to Filter, Blur, and Gaussian Blur. Blur it 3 pixels. Next, we'll illuminate the brick wall behind our neon. But before we do, let's save some space in the Layers panel by collapsing the filters. Shift-click the first Smart Object layer to make it active as well, and press Ctrl or Command J to make a copy of both layers. Convert them into one Smart Object. Ctrl or Command-click its thumbnail to select its shape. Hide the layer and make the dark brick wall active. Alt or Option-click the layer mask icon to make an inverted layer mask next to the dark brick layer. Now that we have a layer mask of our neon's glowing shape, we can delete the top layer by making the top layer active and pressing the Delete key on our keyboard. Lastly, I'll show you how to quickly change the color of the neon sign. Shift-click the first Smart Object to make it active as well, and press Ctrl or Command G to group them into a folder. Click the Adjustment Layer icon and click Hue Saturation. We want the adjustment layer to affect just our neon sign and not the brick wall. However, since adjustment layers affect all the layers below them in the Layers panel, we'll need to restrict it to the folder in which our neon sign resides. To do this, click the Clipping Mask icon, or you can go to Layer and create Clipping Mask. Drag the hue slider to the right or left.
This is Marty from Blue Lightning TV. Thanks for watching.